Hello everyone, this is Neil Davis from Digital Cloud Training. In this video, I'm going to talk about how you can best prepare for your AWS certification exams. Cloud computing is an exciting industry and there's tons of job opportunities, and AWS is at the forefront of cloud computing. So where should you start and what do you need to do to get yourself prepared for an exam? Well, firstly, depending on your background, you may even want to start at the foundational level or the associate level. Now, the foundational level certification is the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner. Then, at the associate level, the most popular certification by far is the AWS Certified Solutions Architect Associate. Now, I highly recommend that if you have no background in cloud computing or in the IT industry itself, you should definitely start at the foundational level. Now, I recommend that everybody does do the Cloud Practitioner. Even if you've got a solid background in cloud computing, you'll find that there are some topics in the Cloud Practitioner that are not covered in the other certifications. So it's a great stepping stone to getting a broad understanding of the AWS cloud. Now, if you do have some background, you can skip straight to the Solutions Architect Associate. Make sure you give yourself plenty of time to study. AWS certifications can take anywhere from a few weeks to a few months. And that really depends on your current knowledge when you start the certification and also how much time you actually put in on a day-to-day basis. So what are the available learning tools? Well, firstly, I highly recommend going to the AWS website and looking up the exam guide for the certification you're interested in taking. That will give you a list of the knowledge areas by domain that will be included in the exam. So that gives you a good guide as to what you need to learn. Most people will use a video-based training course. The advantage of this is the training course has been created specifically for the exam you're going to do. So the instructors will make sure that they teach you the knowledge you need to know for that particular exam. At Digital Cloud Training, we regularly go back to the exam guide as well as finding out what's coming up in the latest exam questions to make sure that we cover everything in the course. Video-based training usually includes a combination of theory and some practical assignments as well. What we do in our courses is we show you through the console how to actually create various solutions on AWS, and you have the opportunity to follow along with those hands-on lessons. That gives you great practical experience and helps you to build your knowledge both at a theoretical level and a practical level. Practice tests are another really useful tool. I recommend you get started with practice tests very early on in your training process. Make sure you're using practice tests that simulate the style, difficulty, and the phraseology and length of the real exam questions. The ones that we write for our courses mirror the types of questions you're going to see on the actual AWS exam. That way, when you turn up on exam day, you're not going to be surprised. You're going to be familiar with the difficulty of the questions and the way that they're phrased, the types of ways AWS might try and trip you up. So definitely use practice tests from very early on. In the study plans we provide to our students, we recommend doing practice tests right from the very first week. That way you get to start assessing your knowledge early on. We also provide cheat sheets with our courses. The cheat sheets give you a consolidated list of the information that you need on exam day. Some certifications, like the Solutions Architect Associate, are extremely broad, so there's so many different topics. If you go to the AWS website, where they do have some really fantastic documentation, you can get a bit overwhelmed with the volume of information that's there. So instead, the cheat sheets consolidate that down to what you need to know. Great for last minute revision before you sit your exam. Finally, another great learning tool is Challenge Labs. Challenge Labs are pre-configured environments where you're given either some detailed instructions on what you need to do and you're going to build out a solution on AWS, or you're told what type of solution you need to build with some specific criteria and you need to be able to use your own skills to implement that solution. And then the solution is validated and you're given a score. So Challenge Labs are a great way to both learn new skills and test your abilities. I hope those tips help you, and if you like this video, please click the like button below and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more information about AWS certification.